Hey everyone, and welcome. Today, we're going to jump right into stock options. And trust me, by the end of this, you'll have a rock-solid understanding of the two most important parts of a put option, the strike price and the expiration date. So, picture this. You own stock in a company you really believe in, but you've got that nagging feeling, you know, that nervousness that the market could take a nosedive. How do you protect yourself? It's a question every single investor asks, and believe it or not, a put option is a really powerful answer. All right, here's our game plan. We're going to break this down into four simple parts. First, we'll talk about why options are basically like insurance for your stocks. Then, we'll get into the payout, that's the strike price. After that, we'll talk about the ticking clock, which is the expiration date. And finally, we'll put it all together to see how the price of this protection is actually figured out.
Okay, so let's start with the big idea. Let's just forget all the complicated Wall Street jargon for a minute. At its heart, you should think of a put option as a simple solution to that problem we just talked about, protecting your hard-earned investment.
Now, okay, that's the textbook definition. A bit dry, right? But what does it really mean for you? Well, the easiest way to think about it is as an insurance policy for your stock. You're paying a small fee, that's called a premium, to protect yourself if the price drops. It gives you the right to sell, but here's the key. You're not forced to. You're in control.
To make this all super clear, we're going to stick with one example the whole way through. Let's imagine you own shares of Teva, and right now the stock is trading at exactly $20 a share. Just keep that $20 number in your head as we go.
So if a put option is our insurance policy, the next logical question is, what actually makes it pay out? And that brings us to our first really key term, the strike price. The strike price is basically the price you get to lock in. It's the price you have the right to sell your Teva stock for, and it doesn't matter how low the actual market price might fall. In our insurance analogy, this is the exact value you're insuring your stock for.
And this is where the strategy really starts to come in. So you can choose from a whole bunch of different strike prices, and your choice directly impacts how much that insurance policy is going to cost you. So how does that work?
Let's just walk through this table. Remember, our stock is at $20. Now, if you pick a $25 strike price, you're getting the right to sell your stock for $5 more than it's worth right now. That's a great deal, right? It's called being in the money. And because it has immediate built-in value, it's the most expensive option here. Let's say $7. A $22 strike is also in the money, but a little less so the cost comes down to maybe $2.80. But now what if you choose an $18 strike? Well, that's out of the money. That means the stock actually has to fall before your protection even starts. And because that protection isn't a sure thing, the cost is way, way lower, maybe just 60 cents. The bottom line is simple. The more valuable the protection you want, the more you're going to pay for it.
Okay, awesome. So we set our payout level with the strike price, but, and this is a big but, just like your car insurance, this protection doesn't last forever. That brings us to our second key component, the expiration date.
Yep, it's pretty much exactly what it sounds like. This is the final day your contract is valid. If you haven't used your right to sell your stock by this date, the option just, well, it expires. It vanishes and your coverage is over.
And the trade-off here is really simple to grasp. An option that expires in a year gives the stock way more time to potentially drop than one that expires in just 2 months. More time means more uncertainty and a higher chance of something happening, which makes that long-term protection more valuable and, you guessed it, more expensive.
All right, let's tie this all together now. We've looked at the payout trigger, that's our strike price, and we've looked at the time limit, the expiration date. These two things are really the main drivers behind how much an option is going to cost.
And this all boils down to two golden rules of pricing put options. Rule number one, the higher your strike price is, the more that option is going to cost. You're simply paying for better protection. And rule number two, the farther out the expiration date is, the more that option is going to cost. You're paying for more time on the clock.
So ultimately, it's all just a balancing act. Choosing a put option is about finding that sweet spot, the right mix of coverage and cost that works for your personal strategy. You're constantly weighing how much protection you think you need versus how long you think you'll need it.
So the question I'll leave you with is this. When you think about your own investments, where do you draw that line? What's the right balance for you between the cost of that protection and the amount of risk you're willing to handle? That right there is the strategic decision every single investor has to make. Thanks for joining us.